Post-quantum WireGuard, in short PQ WireGuard, is a new VPN protocol that provides full security against quantum attacks, including confidentiality, authenticity, perfect forward secrecy, etc. It's based on the original WireGuard protocol. This is a joint work of multiple people in the Netherlands. The authors are listed here in alphabetical order. The rest of the presentation is organized as follows. First, we introduce the original WireGuard protocol and PQ WireGuard. We briefly discuss their security properties. Afterwards, we present our instantiation of the PQ WireGuard protocol and its performance. WireGuard is a VPN protocol presented by Donenfeld at NDSS 2017 and was merged into mainland Linux kernel in 2020. It's a simple protocol with opinionated choice of cryptography. Supporting only one crypto suite avoids a negotiation phase, which reduces the number of handshake packets and eliminates any potential negotiation attacks. The choice of modern cryptography, for example, X25519 for elliptic curve Diffie-Hellman key exchange, achieves high performance. The WireGuard protocol considers an initiator Alice and a responder Bob. Both Alice and Bob have a long-term key pair generated with X25519. Their long-term public keys are assumed to be exchanged before any handshake takes place, in at least an authenticated manner. This assumption is practical, considering how VPN is set up in real-world applications. The core of the WireGuard protocol involves two routing values that are computed locally on both sides, a chaining key material and a hash result. The chaining key material is updated by mixing in total 4 shared Diffie-Hellman results during the handshake, and is used to generate intermediate encryption keys for authenticated encryption. For example, a timestamp is protected with authenticated encryption with one such intermediate key to prevent replay attacks. The final session keys are also derived from the chaining key material when the handshake finishes. The hash value is similarly updated during the handshake, but by mixing information specific to the handshake, for example, the timestamp, the informal public keys, and so on. The hash result is used as the header for authenticated encryption throughout the handshake. Both sides never send their chaining key material nor the hash results over the wire. Instead, they compute them independently and should derive the same values in the absence of active attackers. To start a handshake, Alice generated an ephemeral X25519 key pair. By combining Bob's long-term public key with her long-term and ephemeral private key, she can compute two Diffie-Hellman results, K1 and K2, which are mixed into the chaining key material. When Bob receives the ephemeral public key from Alice, he can compute K1 and K2 similarly. Hence, after the first packet of the handshake, Alice and Bob share two secret Diffie-Hellman results. Now, to create a response, Bob generates his ephemeral key pair. He combines his ephemeral private key with Alice's long-term and ephemeral public keys, respectively, to compute another two Diffie-Hellman results, K3 and K4. He mixes them into the chaining key material. After Alice receives Bob's ephemeral public key, she can compute K3 and K4, increasing the number of shared secrets to 4. Alice then mixes K3 and K4 into the chaining key material to derive the final session keys. She may now send encrypted application data to Bob. At this point, the handshake finishes for Alice, but not for Bob. The application data packets from Alice acts implicitly as the key confirmation. Consequently, Bob may not send any application data until he receives the first data packet from Alice. The WireGuard protocol provides the following security properties. Key confidentiality. The established session key is indistinguishable from true random bit strings for the attacker. Perfect forward secrecy is provided. Key uniqueness. The established session key does not repeat with overwhelming probability. Entity authentication. It's impossible to impersonate another party. Identity hiding. The identities of the initiator and the responder are not revealed from the protocol. Note that an attacker might still be able to infer the identities from, for example, IP addresses. And replay attack resistance with the timestamp. Unknown key share attack resistance. The Diffie-Hellman results of the long-term key pairs of Alice and Bob is mixed into the final session keys, which binds the keys to their identities. DOS attack mitigation. The The initiation packet is authenticated by the Diffie-Hellman results of the long-term key pairs of Alice and Bob. The responder will reject forged initiation packets before performing any expensive public key computation. The security of the WireGuard protocol is established by Dowling and Patterson in a computational model with the notion of ECK, PFS, PSK security. This notion covers all security properties above except session key uniqueness, identity hiding, and DOS mitigation. Donenfeld and Milner have also proven partially the security properties in the symbolic model, but perfect forward secrecy, replay attack resistance, and DOS mitigation were not proven. The role of the preshare key in WireGuard is mainly to provide key confidentiality against quantum attacks. The assumption is that by the time a sufficiently powerful quantum computer comes around, the preshare key will have been erased by both the initiator and responder and cannot be recovered. However, in most commercial scenarios where the VPN users do not control both ends, this assumption relies on the compliance of VPN service providers. In addition, the preshare key must not be compromised, for example, by hacking the system throughout its lifetime. Those are major drawbacks of this approach. Donenfeld claimed explicitly that post-quantum cryptography is not practical for use here, hence the choice of preshare key. This is not true, as we will see shortly. The desired rationale of PQ WireGuard is to achieve quantum resistance and need security level 3, and to retain all security properties of WireGuard. We aim for efficient one round trip handshake, and we will avoid packet fragmentation, because fragmented packets might be dropped or be filtered by firewalls. Therefore, there's a packet size constraint. The amount of space in an IPv6 packet is limited to roughly 1100 bytes for both the initiation and response. This constraint alone prevents WAN from using many NIST candidates already. As explained earlier, the WireGuard protocol is based on X25519, which does not have an efficient, well-analyzed post-quantum replacement. Therefore, we replace the Diffie-Hellman-based key exchange by one based on KEMS. In short, WAN replaces the long-term key pair for identity with a key pair of an IND CCA secure KEM, and the two ephemeral key pairs with one key pair of an IND CPA secure KEM. Note that there is no drop-in replacement for the Diffie-Hellman result of the long-term X25519 key pairs, which is a form of non-interactive key exchange. Not having this shared secret has some consequences, which we will discuss shortly and fix. In addition, to allow a straightforward security proof, we add an explicit key confirmation message as suggested by Dowling and Patterson. In other words, the first application data from Alice no longer serves implicitly as key confirmation anymore. The protocol looks like this. For details, please refer to our paper. It turns out this straightforward approach already achieves all but three of WireGuard's security properties, and we address the missing ones as follows. Key confidentiality. The attacker can compromise the random number generators of Alice and Bob. In this case, PQ WireGuard does not achieve any security. To mitigate this issue, we combine samples from the random number generator with a long-term secret sigma with a pseudo-random function. In practice, this long-term secret sigma can be stored, for example, on a smart card. A non-key share attack resistance. Due to the lack of a replacement of the Diffie-Hellman results of the long-term key pairs, a non-key share attack is possible. One easy fix is to mix Bob's long-term public key into the chaining key material. Here we take another approach. We set the default preshare key to the hash value of XORing the long-term public keys of Alice and Bob. This way, we also ensure that the final session keys are linked to the identities. DOS attack mitigation. The initiation message cannot be authenticated without a replacement of the Diffie-Hellman results of the long-term key pairs. This is not a security property in the cryptographic sense. User who wishes to achieve the same level of DOS mitigation as WireGuard can send out a preshare key. With those adjustments, PQ WireGuard retains all security properties of WireGuard. PQ WireGuard is proven secure both in the computational and symbolic model. As Dowling and Patterson did for WireGuard, we proved the security properties of PQ WireGuard in the computational model with respect to ECK, PFS, PSK. The difference is that adversaries are allowed to be quantum polynomial time algorithms. Our symbolic model extends that of Donenfeld and Milner to allow attackers to compromise random number generators, and we cover all security properties. For instantiation, in principle, one can instantiate PQ WireGuard with any post-quantum cams that meet the aforementioned requirements. We choose the INDCC secure class in McAleese for the long-term key pair, and it took the INDCPA secure variants of Sabre for the ephemeral key pair. Our instantiation reaches NIST security level 3, which is roughly equivalent to AES-192 for quantum attackers, without increasing the number of packets nor incurring packet fragmentation. Since PQ WireGuard particle does not generate long-term key pair nor sending a long-term public key, the drawbacks of classic McAleese, namely slow key generation, a large public keys do not matter. In addition, its ciphertext is very small, and its operations are efficient and can be easily implemented in a manner that receives timing attacks. Its decapsulation also has no failure probability. Finally, it's regarded as one of the most conservative post-quantum cams. Given the history of cryptanalysis efforts, classic McAleese is therefore the ideal choice for the long-term cam. With classic McAleese fixed, the remaining amount of space in the packet unfortunately only permits slow post-quantum cams, or cams without history of sufficient cryptanalysis for the ephemeral key pair. We noticed that, however, some of the lattice-based INDCC secure cam almost meets the space constraint. We therefore picked its Sabre, dropped its Fujisaki-Okamoto transformation, since we only need INDCPA security here. We then took the parameters of Sabre to further compress its public key and ciphertext. The final variant, which we call Dagger, has a higher security strength than Sabre because of higher compression level, but it has a larger failure probability for decapsulation. On the particle level, such failure probability means one in every 40 million handshake will fail. This has a similar effect as a lost UDP handshake packet, and our tweaking does not invalidate Sabre's security reduction. We implemented our instantiation of PQ WireGuard as a Linux kernel module. The implementations of both classic McAleese and Dagger are resistant against timing attacks. Classic McAleese is implemented efficiently, while there is some room for improvement for Dagger. We compare the handshake efficiency with the following matrix: the amount of traffic in bytes, the number of exchanged packets, and the time span of the handshake. We collected our data in both IPv4 and IPv6 networks, and the results are similar. Here, we only include the data from an IPv6 network. We compare its performance with the original WireGuard and other VPN software, including OpenVPN, IPsec, and PQ Crypto VPN. PQ Crypto VPN is a variant of OpenVPN from Microsoft Research that provides confidentiality and, optionally, authenticity against quantum attacks. For WireGuard, the matrix includes the first application data packets, which serves implicitly as key confirmation. We use zero-length application data here. Our experiments show that PQ WireGuard increases client time and server time by 70% and 50% respectively, and that the computation of both WireGuard and PQ WireGuard are dominated by public key cryptography. Therefore, the longer elapsed time on both sides is a direct result of migrating from X25519 to classic McAleese and Dagger. We will expect that further optimization on the implementation can bring PQ WireGuard even closer to the performance of WireGuard. When comparing with other VPN software, PQ WireGuard outperforms in terms of every matrix, except it's slightly larger traffic than that of IPsec using X25519. PQ WireGuard, however, is still 4 times faster than IPsec with X25519, and more than 1,000 times faster than any OpenVPN variant. This shows that PQ WireGuard offers full protection against quantum attacks while being more performant than any other widely deployed VPN software, except for the original WireGuard. And this is our presentation. Thank you for your attention.